Welcome back to the shop, guys. Another week-long heat wave. Hit 109 here in the shop, so yeah, I haven't been outside. If you're looking for machining, you're not going to see it in this video. I'm just doing a proof of concept. Always drooled over, whatever, the Sterrett Precision Level. Saw Ox Tools, had a video on how to use one and calibrate and check different surfaces for flatness. So, I was actually shocked on how accurate or sensitive this thing came out. If you want to make one, you can always buy just the vial alone, replacement vial for the Sterrett level. I just used a cheap one, which you'll see here, so hope you enjoy. Well, I don't know. I always see everybody with this Sterrett Precision Level, and I keep looking at them on eBay. Average about $150. Used one's pretty bad to try to restore. Have no idea. I've seen everybody using them, but I have no idea what I would do with one to justify that kind of money. So for grins and giggles, I'm thinking, maybe let me just make one. This guy, this is for a string, goes through here to check the level. He seems like he's pretty sensitive. I put 1/1000th feeler gauge under here and couldn't see anything, 2/1000th, and I could see the bubble move. So what it's worth. I was thinking about, a huge one by half inch piece of scrap. I was thinking about doing a 1x1 and machining it all like the Sterrett is, but that's just way too much. So I'll make a little post on both sides and all the other stuff to try to do it. So, and I'm not going to make the shell. All right, here goes nothing, huh? How do you bust it open? Yeesh. Boy, it's pretty tight, and I don't want to mess up the bubble, huh? Yeah, I can't do it this way. Pry it out? Yeah, you can pry it out. I need a different set of dikes, nice and fine, so I can just nibble away at it. So, I don't know. A bunch of machining. I'm not going to V-groove because it's so thin, so I'll probably just take a channel out, run an end mill through there, get this thin enough, then I can lap it to make sure it's flat. Then I'm just the adjustments will do the leveling on it. So let's see what happens here. Let me take it apart. Well, that came apart pretty easy with a little fine pair of dikes. Chewing it up, slid right out. I was shocked. Well, I did remember too. I was expecting this to be bowed. And I did put a mark, it's over here, black marks a lot, Sharpie or whatever. So I knew what was up. I put this on the granite surface. This is straight. So that's crazy to me. I guess that's probably to my benefit, because that means it's about as sensitive as it can get being straight. Probably should play with it too on... Yeah, I could probably do this and see that the bubble stays in the same spot no matter where it's rotated. Looks like it is, but I'll check it carefully on a level surface. And I was hoping, because half inch, I think this is half inch, turned down a little bit. Where is this? Yeah, 499. Half inch kind of looked like it was too big on this block, but you put it up against this thing and whoa. So, and measuring this, this was what, 372, I think, somewhere in there. Yeah, 372, 371.5. So a 3/8 end mill, 375, will give me the pocket. Probably put some glue or something, JB Weld in there or something maybe to hold it in place. So I think before starting with this, I should make the two end pieces first. Take a piece of half inch, clean it up, turn it, pocket it. Then cut it off, because then it's got to go in the mill to create the flat and put the hole in it. I should probably right now to collect what hardware I'm going to use for this thing. So here we go. I'm scrounging around to see who it screws, and I don't have anything, so I was thinking about making my own brass screw. See how it turns out, but half inch piece. Crazy. I tried the 3/8 end mill, way too sloppy. I tried a bunch of different things with drill bits, too sloppy. It's like, duh, dummy, bore it out. So I bored it 394 thousandths, and it did go in there a minute ago. Yeah, there it is. So, So what? Yeah, had it perfect and had it over here thinking about it. So, you know, well, let me knurl it. That might make it look pretty cool. And of course, the knurl shrank it down. So now I had to recapture it. You got to deal with the run out, but it fits. So, oh, nice, perfect. You heard the vacuum. So now I'll definitely have to put this in a collet, finish cleaning this up, and then move it to the end mill and give the flat tab. Not sure how I'm going to do the round yet. Don't want to do it with a file. So this collet may go on the rotary table and carefully take light cuts to get it there. Kind of wish that was bigger, more bigger, or this was more smaller than this, but right on it, you know, I can't go in any further, it's going to fall right off. So I'm just going to proceed with it, see how it looks, and I'm going to get back in there. Yeah, there. See how it winds up looking? That should look pretty cool, I guess. Oh, I can make that a lot shorter to 4 inches. I think it's 4.5. So once I get this kind of done, that does look big, though. We'll see, especially when it's rounded. So, status so far. Hindsight, it's always 20/20, right? After screwing around and messing this part up. Should have just used an end mill to begin with rather than drill bits and then bore it out. Went too deep on it, cut it off, then tried to hold it in an ER32 here. Figured for the radius, let me do a heavy chamfer to try to kind of get there. Grabbed it, jammed the machine, blew the fuse. Ay, what a mess. Thank God for the old UHF guy at gmail.com, the guy that repairs these controllers, gave me a bunch of suggestions, got it back online. Looks like blowing the fuse damaged the fuse holder. So I've got a bunch of parts on order. Gonna replace the power switch, the fuse holder, and the potentiometer because the click part broke a long time ago. So just do it all. So now, yeah, use an end mill. I got a nice square bottom, bored out, good tight fit. Knurled it first. That's right, I knurled this and then closed it down. Then you gotta try to bore it out again. And then while it's in the holder here, mill this off. So now I can cut it off and I can drill the hole right now. Yeah, while it's still like that, rather than trying to hold it here. So, I think, you know, probably the size of a screw to go in there, I think I'm just going to chamfer the edges, clean the end off, and then just give it a slight chamfer and say that's it. Would be really nice to have something that protects this, like that shell on the sterret, but I can't think of anything yet, so... That side goes in nice and easy. This one's tight, but yeah, it does. Oh yeah, it fits in snug. We don't want to push it in yet. Probably a burr on this thing or something. Oop, push it down. See, there's the alignment. But be interesting to see when I'm done just how sensitive or not sensitive this thing is. So just an update where I am. Probably looks like this thing's going to be way down here, 4 inches. Yeah, that's about 4. I don't have a ruler here, but onward and upward. Now, think about this. Finish him off, cut him off, and then make the other half here. Figured out what I'm going to do. Don't want to do the same mistake twice. Holding it in a collet here, so put it in here. Tilt it to 45, or I can use a 45 cutter and get these edges. So I'm going to put this in the bandsaw this way. And then I can cut right up there, clean it up. And I guess I do have to still hold it to clean up the face. Take minimal cuts, let me tell you. But let's do it. Well, I was taping a lot of doing this stuff, but then I started watching what was recorded, and I've been drilled so many times for yada, yada, yada. I talk too much, get on with it, get to the point. So I thought I'd just really shorten this up. I always see everybody with the stare at precision level, keep drooling over it. Why? I don't know. The ones I can afford, they're just wrecked to me beyond restoration. So, and then the new ones, 140 up, I can't justify spending that kind of money for something like that. So I figured, what the heck, let me just play around and see if I can make one. A string line level for doing landscaping. String goes through there and you stick it in the middle and bar it out. So I tore one apart. Turns out I was shocked it's straight. I would have thought the thing was bowed, but no. And thinking about it, that's to my benefit because that'll be make it as sensitive as possible. Showed in the last video, knurling works every time. Biorhythms low, made a lot of mistakes. Tried drilling it. I tried an end mill first, way too sloppy. Tried drilling it, made a mess of that. Duh. Use an end mill, bore it out. Perfect fits on it. I'm within a half a thou. This one got wrecked because I tried to hold this end in a collet, which was stupid because it bent and stalled the machine, blew the fuse, and I think it screwed up my control board. So I'll be showing a video on that, probably restoring it. So now, smart me, keep it in this. I actually turned it. I knurled it because my mistake was I thought about knurling it afterwards and it shrank it, so I had to go in and bore it again. So knurl it, end mill it, bore it out so I got the size, come over with a parting tool and just clean this down. Now it's in the collet, which goes in the mill, and I flatten out this end and drill the hole. I'm going to go with a 4mm set up on it because the hole seems fine. Wish I could really round that, but for now I'm just going to stay with this chamfer. Yeah, that's what I was trying to do on this, give it a heavy chamfer to get to this point, and that's when it just caught and jammed. So this goes in the end mill, burt, and then flip it over, burt, flip it on its what did I do here? No, I did a different thing. Okay, then flip it on its side, bandsaw it off. Then I was afraid of messing it up, so I'm holding it in this guy, putting it in the vise, and then I can easily solid hold it to do this little bevel thing. So that's where I am so far, and I was thinking about making my own kind of brass setup base. I figured I better make this first, then deal with the base. I was going to mill a huge piece, square piece, so it looked like a sterret, but it's way too much work. So I'm just going to do this piece here, and it'll be pretty darn short, so it'll be probably right in here. Lap it, clean it all up, make posts or whatever. So I'll probably come back when I'm starting the base, or maybe done and showing how sensitive or not sensitive this is. I did play with it on the bench on the granite plate, and I put 1/1000th under here. Wouldn't see it move. Put 2/1000th gauge, what do you call them, shoot? A gauge, whatever. Feeler gauge under here, and the bubble moved. So I'm somewhere between 1/2000th sensitive. Anything else to say right now? Yeah, you go to Home Depot, pick these up if you didn't know they existed. And that's it. So I'm just, it's ready now to go into the mill and get this stuff all done. Okay, so far, so good. A couple of decisions I have to make. One is the length of this base. And I was thinking about it, get the mic cord out. If you have a flat surface, well, okay, that's level. If you have a flat surface at some angle, it doesn't matter whether you're from here to here in length, because you can still read the angle, or from here to here. So length doesn't matter if I'm, you know, trying to find the angle of a flat surface, which I usually am doing. But as OxTool showed in one video, if you're trying to check something that's kind of crooked, if you're long, you're going to measure the angle from here to here. Bert. If you're short, you're going to be measuring from here to here. You get one reading from, say, here to here, another reading. So you can kind of tell just how flat a surface is. Now, I don't know how sensitive this is really going to be until I'm done with it, but I am going to just try to keep it as short as possible anyway. The other decision is, you know, the stair, it's always had this little level here for tilt. Since this thing was straight, as I said in the past, it doesn't matter whether I'm angled or not. So I'm not going to bother putting this on. So I'm figuring 300 thousandths per side, fine. That's going to put it at, what was it, like 3.7 inches. So that'll be the length. Yeah, here's where I'm going to cut it, somewhere in there. Then I'm going to just heavy chamfer all the sides. Okay. Now, putting the posts in, I figured I'm just going to use a spring and see how it works. Compress it pretty good for the adjustment side. So it'll be a short post. So I'll hit, well, I don't even think I have to draw it, but yeah, short post, screw, and a spring. There, that's the adjustment. This side, looking at the stair, because I'm trying to figure out, you know, if you just put a bolt in here, or a screw or whatever, it ain't gonna tilt. So, looking at the stairs, what I think they did is they made a cup. How did it go? Oh yeah, it goes on top. Somehow I'm thinking they made a cup here, but they angled inside of it. And then they have a screw that's also got an angle to match it, so it can pivot. But I haven't paid attention to the bottom, because you're going to have your piece here. So now the top can pivot, but you need something on the bottom. So I got to figure this one out, what I want to do. I was thinking about, okay, maybe just make a post that's got a point to it with the screw threads or something through it, so it just pivots on the base down here. So you just got to give that some thought and move on. But so far, I think it looks pretty cool. Still not completed with this thing, but it is pretty darn sensitive. Just the weight of this camera on the bench shifted it. This is 2/1000ths right here. Try to lift this up. Oh, I can't let that sit on the table. But I'm not sure if you can see the bubble. But when I pull this out, you'll see the bubble move. There, it just shifted. I saw it move. Try it again. Let it settle. Bubble looks like it's almost on center to me. And I'll slowly pull it out. I didn't see it move that time. Actually, no, it's more over here now than over there. One more time. It's hard to get it underneath there because it's so flat. Yeah, bubble looks like it's dead center right now. And if I pull it out, I saw it shift. So it's pretty darn sensitive. That's 2/1000ths. What happens if I try a thou? Do I have one in here? Or 1.5? I think I have a 1.5. Where is it? That's 3. Yeah, here's 1.5. All right. Hey, it's hard to... Things are so thin, I don't want to bend them. Ouch. All right, where'd it go? This is it. Yeah, 1.5. All right, try to put everybody away but that one. So there, 1.5 thou, right? I double check it so I can read it. Yeah, 005. Okay, so put that underneath there. And bubble looks like it's almost on center. I didn't see it move. So 2,000ths it detects. And still, it's just floating here right now too. I don't have this other side done over here. It's just bolted here. And it's free to flop in this thing too. So I haven't glued them or anything. But that's pretty good. I just have to figure out how to do this side now.